All right, how's it going? We have another headbanger for you. Last night, Mercyful Fate in Los Angeles at the YouTube Theater in LA. It's connected to SoFi Stadium, right across from the Forum, where I've seen a million shows. If you don't want to hear me talk about the band, hey, just skip right to the concert. It's cool. You know what? Mercyful Fate is one of those bands, they're just legendary, you know? And one way you know is you know when legends show up, like Dave Grohl or Metallica or Rob Halford or Kerry King. You know, all these guys are huge fans of Mercyful Fate for a reason. You know, their music is amazing, great lyrics, great power chords, and just heavy metal. You know, it's indescribable. They're kind of a one-of-a-kind band. I love these guys, you know, and I think that the singer is, you know, King Diamond. He's very gracious. During the concert, he kept saying, like, hi, this is so cool to be here, and I love you guys, and you know, he hasn't done a big tour like this in 20 years, so it's kind of cool to see him, you know, make it back from a triple bypass surgery like 13 years ago and be in good health. He quit smoking. I think his voice is better than it's ever been. I'm sure part of that is Livia, his wife, telling him to be a healthy person for their kid, you know, just like all good wives do. Anyway, I got a cool relic I want to show you guys. Speaking of Dave Grohl, he gave me this here guitar not too long ago, which was awesome. I'll tell that story another day. I have my home office is like a rock and roll museum. If you guys ever want to see it, leave me some comments below. But I've got artifacts and autographs and cool, unique items from, you know, 40 years of doing rock and roll. You know, I've been lucky. But anyway, another little note that's kind of interesting is Kerry King from Slayer was my neighbor. He lived down the street for years and years. He just recently sold his house and moved out. But it was kind of cool watching him roll around the neighborhood in his big black Rolls Royce. He's got a cool license plate. I won't say what it is for his own privacy. But anyway, he's a nice guy. You know, another thing that was kind of a treat about this show was seeing Becky Baldwin out there. You know, I've been a fan of Becky's, watching her in a band from the UK called Hands Off Gretel with Lauren Tate. She's just an amazing bass player. And to see her kind of do a guest appearance, filling in for Joey Vera, like, that's awesome. I know he's got to do his Armored Saint stuff, and he's got some other bands he's in. But she's amazing, man. Keep an eye on that lady. She's great. I know she's probably friends with Livia, and that probably helped kind of make that connection, but I'm sure King Diamond is more than pleased to have her on the tour. So anyway, now I'm going to tell a real interesting story. Before I do that, I want to show you some of the swag from the concert. Of course, got to get the Mercyful Fate Melissa shirt. I mean, check that out. That's cool. The back's got all the tour dates on there, which is awesome. Of course, I'm wearing my Don't Break the Oath shirt. That was a great album. So, little history about my story with Mercyful Fate. When I was in high school, I was getting into all kinds of trouble. And my parents thought the best solution is let's send this kid to a Catholic all-boys high school. So I went to a Jesuit Catholic high school, all boys, in Northern California for a semester. And man, I just did not like that at all. That was horrible. But me and one of my neighborhood friends, his name was Steve Elizondo, we were big fans of Mercyful Fate. And I had the cassette and he had the album. And we would listen to it on the way to school. And we really wanted the lyrics. So we had this great idea to get the album, because Steve had the album, and take it into the school office and make photocopies of the lyrics for each other so that we could kind of sing along the songs. And what do you know? A nun caught him making photocopies and started reading the lyrics, called his parents and called my parents, and we're like so concerned that we were worshiping the devil, and we weren't really at all. Like, that's not my thing, and it wasn't his either. But just hilarious. I had a lot of explaining to do to my parents around that. But it's just kind of funny being in an all Catholic high school, you know, and having a nun bust you for making photocopies of Mercyful Fate lyrics. And it was the Melissa album, you know, so even better. So I was kind of like banned from listening to Mercyful Fate, but I did it anyway. When I was mowing lawns as a kid and Don't Break the Oath came out, you better believe I was listening to that. That was awesome. So anyway, another reason I'm kind of excited about this, believe it or not, this is the first time I've seen Mercyful Fate. I was supposed to go see them in 2019, and I bought tickets like 4 months in advance on the East Coast. I was all excited, and then about 3 weeks before the show, I realized that my wife had also scheduled for the whole family to go to Disney World that exact same weekend. So I had to sell my tickets, and I was like super bummed, but I think it all worked out for the best because I got to see Becky Baldwin, and I think I got to see a more evolved, fine-tuned King Diamond. He sounded amazing. My seats at this show are first row in the balcony, so I wasn't bothering anyone filming this thing, and I had a perfect view. I tried to capture the lights. I didn't zoom in a lot and get a lot of close-ups. It was very like fog on. There was a lot of like the fog on the stage, and the lighting would have been difficult to get some good close-ups from my vantage point. But the sound is amazing, and you get a really nice view of the lighting setup. YouTube Theater is amazing. Go there and see any show you can see there. The sound is good. It's like brand new. It's clean. It was almost too clean. I was talking to a guy in the, you know, after we came out of the bathroom, like, it just almost doesn't feel right that it's not a little grungy because everything was so nice. It was like luxury, you know, concert experience. It was really cool. So, all right, I'm going to quit blabbing. Enjoy the show. It's amazing. Have a great week.
evening, LA! Feeling all right? It's been way fucking too long, man. Oh, yeah. So we're gonna do a real old one for you now. It's the Corpse Without Soul! We'll be right back. Thank you so much! We're gonna do something new for you now. We are still recording it. As soon as we're done with this tour, it's full power. All the efforts are gonna be put into finishing that song, you know. It's about the Inquisition in Austria, 1675. This is called the Jackal of Salzburg. Thank you. didn't like it, just say it. You liked it? Thank you so much. I think it's time to take a little trip to Egypt. In 1983. Thank you so much! Here's a newer one for you. It's from 1984. This whole thing feels like we could really end up in a very, very dangerous meeting here. think it's time to let you know who's up here. You already know. You know this guy. From King Diamond, right? On the lead guitar, Mr. Mike Wead! You know, there's a local guy here in town who's out touring with Amon State right now. He also plays with us, you know. But he can be two places at one time. You might know him as Joey Vera. This is not Joey Vera. We found this beautiful girl hiding in Birmingham, England. Please welcome Becky Baldwin! And here, my countryman. Been with us forever. Amazing guy. Please welcome on the drums, the one and only Mr. Bjarne T. Hold. I wish I could stay here all night. I do have an obligation after this show. That's why I dressed in this. I don't really want to go. It's a black funeral, you know. We have a little talk over here. We're discussing something. We will play Evil! We'll be right back. unbelievable. Thank you so much. Fucking hell. That means we are all ready now to turn this into a real ritual. But we needed all of you to come to the Sabbath. Do you want more? Okay, someone told me that you prefer short songs in LA. I'm not saying that. Don't you want long songs? I listen to you.
We'll be right back.
Thank you. Good night. It's no presents for Christmas, man, but okay. Thank you so much!
Concert hot dogs. Yeah, because we went by that bag valet there. All right, what do you think, Jackson? What was your favorite song?
I liked the Curse of the Pharaohs.
Curse of the Pharaohs, yeah. Melissa was my favorite. That was good.